Good morning, friends. In the last few lectures, we studied the simply supported beam and simply supported with cantilever beams. So that's why today I am starting third type of the problems. This problem is related with the cantilever beams. So please note down today's first problem: draw shear force and bending moment diagrams for the cantilever as shown in figure. Draw shear force and bending moment diagram as shown in figure. Cantilever 2 meter, 1.5, 1 meter, 2 meter, 15, 20, and 10. So that's why here's first mark point. Suppose this is A, B, C, D. So here's all the loads that comes on the supports A. So that's why R A equal to R A equal to 15 kilonewtons, 20 kilonewtons plus 10 kilonewtons. This is equal to 45 kilo newtons. So that's why you can start shear force calculation. So shear force at A point equal to upward force. This is 45 kilo newton upward. So that's why 45 kilo newton upward. Next point is shear force at B point. So in between A to B, there is no any force. It's up to left hand side above the B points, 45 kilonewtons, and this is 45 minus 15. This is equal to 30 kilonewton. This is also upward. Third, shear force at C point, 30 kilonewtons. And this is 10 kilonewtons downward. So that's why minus, because here positive upwards and negative downwards. So that's why this is 10 kilonewton. Again, this is positive. So that's why this is upward. And last point, shear force at D point. This is equal to 10 minus this 10 equal to 0. Now you can draw shear force diagram. B point, C point, this is B, C, D, and this is A point. So at A point, 45 kilonewtons upward. In between A to B, there is no any force. So that's why this is 45 kilonewton. 45 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton next, and up to this 30 kilonewton, and at C point 20 kilonewtons downwards. So this is 10 kilonewton, and this is positive shear force diagram. This is for cantilever beams. Next, bending moment calculation. So for bending moment calculations, if sections in the x-axis, so this is clockwise, this is negative, because sections in the left hand side, and if the sections this is clockwise and this is upward force, this is our assumptions. So that's why this is sections xx that is to be considered at C point. Bending moment for cantilever beam start from D point. Bending moment at D point equal to, because this is end point, equal to 0, force multiplied by distance equal to 0. So that's why bending moment at C point, now this is clockwise moment, but this is downward type and this is sections in the left hand side. So that's why minus 10 into 1 equal to minus 10 kilonewton meter. Bending moment at B point equal to minus 10 into distance, this is 1 plus 1.5 negative, this 20 kilonewton, and this is, and sections we are considering because we are calculating bending moment at B point. So that's why 20 into 1.5. So this is 25 and this is 30 equal to minus 55 kilonewton meter. And last, bending moment at A point equal to, now here's additional distance 2 meter. So that's why 10, 1 plus 1.5 plus 2, 20 into 1.5 plus 2. Additional moment acting, this is 15 into 2. 15 into 2. 3.5, 35, this is 45, because this is 3.5. 45, this is 3.5 into 20 and 70, and this is 30. So that's why 145 kilonewton meter, right? And so after that you can draw bending moment diagram, and this is shear force diagram, and this is bending moment diagram. So bending moment at A point, this is highest. Suppose this is 145 kilonewton meter. Next point is the at D point, this is 55. Suppose this is 55 kilonewton meter, and this is 10 kilonewton. So no need to write here this is negative, because this downwards of x axis means that indicate this is negative, and this is your bending moment diagram A, B, C, and this is D. So this is straight line, this is straight line. So this is your first problems. Next problem. In this case only we consider concentrated load. Now suppose this load is concentrated, and second problem. Distance 1.5 to 0.5
meter, and this is 0.5.
Uh,
and this is cantilever. A point B, C, D, E.
Force acting 30, 10, 25.
30 kilonewton. Ten kilonewton. This is 10 kilonewton per meter.
So in this case, here R is equal to
RA equal to downward force 30 kilonewton plus 10 into this distance 2 meter, so that's why multiplied by 2 plus 25. This is equal to 75 kilonewton and this is upward.
In this case, one additional point, so that's why shear force at E point. Now shear force at A point, upward force 75 kilonewton. So this is 75 kilonewtons upward. Shear force at B point, 75 minus 30, 45 kilonewton. This is also again upwards. So at C point there is no any force, so that's why 45 kilonewton again upwards. Now at D points, this 10 kilonewton per miss 2, so that's why 45 minus 10 into 2, this is equal to 25 kilonewton. And at E point, 25 kilonewton minus 25, this is equal to 0. So that's why draw shear force diagram for A, for B, for C, D, and this is E. 1 meter, 1.5 meter, this is 2 meter, and this is 0.5 meter. 75 kilonewton. Kilonewtons downward, and this is 45 up to this point. Here uniform distributed load, so that is gradually decreasing up to 20, means this is inclined line. This is 25 kilonewton, again 25. This is 25 kilonewton. This is your shear force diagram. This is positive, right? Next, bending moment calculation. Bending moment at E points, for always note down. For bending moment calculation, start from, for cantilever beams, from left, means right hand side. At E points, this is end point, this is equal to 0. Because we are considering sections XX at E point. Next, bending moment at D point. Now sections XX we are considering at D point. And this is clockwise moment, so that's why 25 into 0.5, 12.5, and this is negative kilonewton meter. Now bending moment, next point is at C point, section XX is considered at C point. At C point, Now distance 25 into 0.5 plus this 2 meter, and this uniform distributed load 10 kilonewton multiplied by 2, this is shear force, distance divided by half of its distance, because this is a rectangular type uniform distributed load and it's a center of gravity located half of its distance. So that's why this will get cancelled. 2.5 multiplied by 2, 62.5 minus 20, this is equal to 82.5 kilonewton meter, and this is negative sign means anti-clockwise. Next point is the bending moment at B point. So additional distance here 1.5, 25, 0.5 plus 2 plus this 1.5, because we are calculating bending moment at B points, B sections, XX. So all the moments, three moments, this is because of the force this, and this is second, only two moments. Distance increase negative minus 10 into 2. This is shear force. So always round. So this is for understanding purpose, because this is shear force. Similar, this is this force. This is intensity of the shear force multiplied by distance, means that becomes shear force. Half of its distance, 2 by 2 plus this distance, 1.5. So that's why 25 into 4 minus 100 minus this is 20 into 2.5. 20 into 2.5, this becomes 50 minus 150 kilonewton meter. Again, this is anti-clockwise. And last point is the bending moment at A point. Now sections XX is to be considered at A point. Here three moment, because this additional moment is 30 multiplied by 1. So that's why here increase distance 1 meter minus 25, 0.5 plus 2 plus 1.5 plus 1 minus 10 into 2, 2 by 2, 1.5 plus 1, and negative, this is 30 multiplied by 1, 125, because 0.5, 1.5, 2 plus 2 plus 1, 5, this 2 will get cancelled, and that is 20 into 3.5, 70 minus 30. So this is 225 kilonewton meter. Again, this is anti-clockwise. So that's why this is shear force diagram. Now for bending moment diagram, E point, D point, C point, B point, A point. 225. Suppose this is 225 kilonewton meter. First, mark all points. 150. Suppose this is 150 kilonewton meter. 82.5 kilonewton meter. 12.5. This is 12.5 kilonewton meter. Now this is horizontal line, so that's why here you will get this is horizontal line, and this is uniform distributed load, so that's why this line is the curved line. After that, this is straight line and this is straight line. And this is your bending moment diagram. Bending moment diagram. So in this problems, it is a combination of the uniform distributed load and the point load. Now, third type of the problems is the combination of the uniform distributed load, concentrated load, and when moment acting. So that's why I erase this. This is third type of the problem.
Distance again similar type. No, 2 meter, 2 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter, and 2 meter.
A point, B point, C point, and D point.
Uniform distributed load
over the entire beam, moment acting, and this is concentrated load.
Moment equal to 25 kilonewton
meter. Kilonewton concentrated load
and uniform distributed load 20 kilonewton per meter.
This is per meter. So that's why here now 4 point. Here only 4 point. So that's why RA equal to because all the forces and uniform distributed loads and moment acting at the support A. So that's why 50 kilonewton concentrated load plus, so this distance 1 meter, this is 1 meter, and this is 2 meter multiplied by 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 2. This is 80 plus 50, 130 kilonewtons and upward. Bending moment at A points, this is positive 130 kilonewton. Up to B point 130 kilonewton, and this uniform distributed load minus 25 into 1 equal to 105 kilonewtons. This is upward. Bending moment at C point, here bending moment at shear or shear force at A just at left hand side of C point, because here two forces acting, so that's why you have to consider left hand side. 105 minus this in between load 25 into 1, this is equal to 80 kilonewton. Again, this is now bending moment at C point or shear force at सी पॉइंट 80 किलो न्यूटन्स, डाउनवर्ड फोर्स 50 किलो न्यूटन. आई डिड मिस्टेक, इट वॉज 25. ओह, सो दिस इज नॉट द केस. 25, राइट, इंटू 1. ओह, दिस इज 20 into 1. इट्स नॉट बिकॉज 20 किलो न्यूटन मीटर, सो दैट्स वाई दिस इज 110 किलो न्यूटन. अगेन दिस इज 20. Just left hand side 110 into 20.1, and this is equal to 90 kilonewton. 90 minus 50 kilonewton, this is equal to 40 kilonewton. This is again upwards. Next point is the shear force at D point. This is 40 minus 20 into distance. This is equal to 0. So draw first shear force diagram. Project all point. A, B, C and D point. And this is 130. Suppose this is 130. This is also 110. Again, straight line 90 kilonewton. Here 50 kilonewton downwards is 40 kilonewton and 40 to 0. And this is your shear force diagram. I think you understand this. Next is the bending moment calculations. For bending moment, start from end points. Bending moment at a D point equal to 0. Next, bending moment at C point. Here 20 into 2, and shear force half of its distance. Right, so that's why minus 40 kilonewton meter. And this is uniform distributed load, means you will get curved line. Bending moment at B point, but here moment acting, so that's why bending moment just right hand side of B point. Minus This is 20 into distance 1 plus 2. Half of its distance 3 by 2. And this is 50 multiplied by 1. Right. So this is 3 multiplied by 3 divided by 2. This is 1.5, 4.5, 90 minus 50. This is equal to minus 140 kilonewton meter. And bending moment at A point. Now, total uniform distributed load minus 20 into total distance 4, and this is half because moment. And just right hand side above the B point, here again clockwise moment 25. Just right hand side, this is clear. So this is 140. Now, because another one point here, bending moment just left hand side of B point, because here moment actings 140 minus 25 minus 165 kilonewton meter. This is clear. So bending moment at A point. So this is end point, but this you will not get zero value because this is cantilever beam. Minus 20 into 4 into half its distance. So this becomes shear force, and half its distance minus 50 into 2. And couple actings, this is 25 moment, or you can say this is couple, this is 2, 20 into 6 minus 120 minus 100 minus 25, this is 245 kilonewton meter. Is there I did mistake? 50 into 2, 24, 20 into 4, 2 divided by 2, 120, 50 into 2, 'cause my answer is different, so that's why I'm checking. Mm. because this is 20 into 4, 160 multiplied by 2. 20 into 4, 80 multiplied by 2, this is 160. So that's why 160, this is equal to 285. All right. So bending moment diagram, CBA, 285, suppose this is 285. Minus 140, 165, 140. C point 40 kilonewton. So that's why this is curved line. This is also curved line. This is straight, again this is curved line, this is your shear force, apply bending moment diagram. Try to understand this bending moment and diagrams. So in these problems, this moment is the clockwise moment. If the moment is anti-clockwise, so similar type of the problems, only difference is when the moment is anti-clockwise. This is fourth problem. Draw again, take headings, shear force and bending moment diagrams for the beam shown in figure. Four meter, 1 kilonewton, 20 kilonewton and 20 kilonewton. Four meter, this is anti-clockwise, and here A point, B point and only C point. At left hand side of the B point, so no necessary shear force at A point, means RA equal to, this is 1 kilonewton per meter, so RA equal to 1 into distance, 4 plus 20, 28 kilonewton upward. Shear force at A point, 28 kilonewton upward. Bending moment at, shear force at B point, minus, because this is uniform distributed load, 1 kilonewton, 1 multiplied by 4, 25 kilonewton. Now shear force at just left hand side of C point, because here 20 kilonewtons load acting. So this 24 again 1 into 4, this is equal to, otherwise if you are confused, 28 minus 1 into 8, this is equal to 20 kilonewton. Try to understand this. Shear force at C point, this is equal to 28 minus 1 into 8 minus concentrated load 20, and this is equal to 0. You can draw shear force diagram. A point, B point, C point, 28. This is uniform distributed load up to this 24 kilonewton, and this is 20 kilonewton. This is your shear force diagram. Right. Next, bending moment calculation. So at the end points, bending moment at C point, equal to 0. Now moment acting at B point, so that's why bending moment just right hand side of B point equal to here 20 into 4 negative minus 1 kilonewton multiplied by 4, so this is shear force, and half of its distance 80, and this is 8 minus 88 kilonewton meter. Bending moment just left hand side of B point. Now sections XX at B point, and this moment is the, so according to the section XX, this is positive moment. So that's why, because this moment is the anti-clockwise, so that's why minus 88 plus 20 minus 68 kilonewton meter, and bending moment at A point. So here minus 20 into 4 plus 4 minus 1 into distance and half of its distance, and plus couple acting positive, and this is 20. 20 into 8, 160. This is 4, 8 into 4, minus 30 plus 20, 192 plus 20, means 172 kilonewton meter, and this is anti-clockwise. So that's why 192. So after that, 68 This is 68 kilonewton meter. This is your positive bending moment diagram. So here, this line is the curved line. This curve is the nature of the curve is the parabolic curve. This curve is the parabolic curve, so because of the uniform distributed loads. This is your bending moment diagrams. So I think due to limitations of the times, I stop here. And because I already taken 4 problems, so in the next class we'll see some of the problems related with the shear post bending moment diagram, and after that we can see if the when the shear force diagrams is given, draw load diagram and draw bending moment diagrams, and when the bending moment diagrams given, so draw shear force diagrams and draw load diagrams and shear force diagrams, so reverse. So that such type of the problems we'll see in the remaining 2-3 classes, that is for shear force and bending moments. Some of the again cases we have to consider when the load is given, so in terms of the uniform distributed loads, other types, so what is the relations. So such type of the multiple choice questions may be asked during the examinations, so that's why some of the or one more again class I will engage for that purpose in the your third or fourth class, means within 3 or 4 class I will complete this chapter shear force bending moment, and we can start the fourth unit. In the fourth unit, that is the shear force or shearing stresses and bending stresses chapters. So the actually there that are the 2 chapters in the fourth unit, and after that fifth unit is the I think torsions and columns and thrust, and sixth unit is the deflections of the beam. So that's why within 3 or 4 class I will complete this chapters is the shear force and bending moment diagrams. So if you have any questions related with the any topics or any chapters, you can ask me at any times. So my number is, you notes, 94237. You can call me freely at any times if you are facing any problems related with the strength of material. Thank you.